Muslim means the one who submit his will to the will of God, the way Jesus submitted his will to the will of God. This is exact replica verbatim. Jesus Christ was a Muslim. Musa al-Islam was, Moses was Muslim. And all the certain laws and social laws were there, and every law has a nature and the tendency to change the character of the people over the period of time. So laws were changing due to the need of the people, but the fundamentals of God Almighty is always intact, remains one. Allah is one. Allah says in the Quran, I never told any prophet to claim himself that he is God. Show me who prophet said it. Show me in the Bible, which prophet, show me in Bhagavad Gita, show me in Quran, show me any holy scripture where prophet himself claimed these two words. I'm speaking in Arabic now. I'm going to translate except verbatim. He claimed from his mouth, not what people supposed to be, you know, taking it, or people ought to be meant, or people in as much so, but yani maslan, no. He must say from his mouth, An Allah, I am God, fa'budni, worship me. You know, Christians, when we keep asking them, where did Jesus claim? Where did Jesus say? Where does Allah claim in the Quran that he is God, worship me? Show us the same thing. Here, in Surah Taha, chapter 20, Allah says, An Allah, fa'budni, I am God, and worship me. Show these two statements towards any prophet, forget about Jesus. Any prophet, you see, we Muslims are ready to accept you guys. Because Allah says in the Quran, never. And the fundamental teachings of Moses, Jesus, Muhammad, and all the prophets from Adam up to Muhammad Arabi, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was not an iota difference in the fundamentals. Matlab, mana, like God is one, he has with no partners. This concept of Tawheed is to be found in every fundamental teachings of the prophets. Yes, the social law, political laws, and economical laws are varied. We accept that. But fundamentals never change. God is not variable. God is constant, not like Bible and Christianity. For thousands of years, God is saying 1, 1, 1. And when Jesus said, God is changed into Trinity. And then you try to fit and force, stampede all your Trinity into previous scriptures somehow by the hook or by the crook, that, you know, it sounds like more Trinitarian concept. You will fail, and you will fail till doomsday. You can't prove it. There is no concept, historical record, that Jews and before the advent of Jesus Christ, that there was such a thing, Trinity. Yeah, we do find in Hinduism Trinity, this Trimurti, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, and all these other creation, this, but yes, you will never find these concepts in the real way of the prophet's lips. From prophet lips, you will never find that prophet says Trinity. Prophets always say Tawheed, worship one thy Lord which art in the heaven, and call no man your father on this earth, as there is only one your father which art in the heaven. Matthew 23:9. Jesus and John chapter 17 verse number 3 and onwards. Father, glorified your prophet, glorified me. For what? That the work you have given to me, I have completed. And what I completed? That I glorified only you. You only. Only. You know what's the meaning of only? Go and read English if you don't know. Or your own language, vernacular language. Only means only. This is what only also emphasizing. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. He's the only, alone, tanha. So what say? Allah says, Jesus says to God, God Almighty, now appreciate me that I have completed my work which thou hast given to me. And what was the work? Not to die on the cross, he said. The work you gave us to me, I have finished. That your son has glorified you. And you, only you. The only person to be glorified is you. That thou art the only true God. You are the only Al-Haq. And Jesus Christ whom thou hast sent. So, Allah says, if this the case, you Jews and Christians, produce the religion name of Abraham. Now many people will tell Christians, you know, these clever Christians always ready to make insult of themselves. They will come and tell you, okay, you don't need any name for Abraham. He didn't bring any laws and nature. He didn't bring anything. He doesn't need anything to say. What does he need to say then? When he came to those people, what he was telling them? What he was telling them? To follow me, to follow who? To follow Jesus, follow Moses, follow Muhammad, or follow what concept he was telling to his people? When the people inquired him, Abraham, what do you preach us? What does he say? You people don't understand. Muslim, Islam is a natural phenomenon. It's a philosophy of submitting yourself to the Allah. You don't need any kind of a label or a title. Label is giving to you for convenience. Allah says in the Quran, everything is Muslim. Mountains are Muslim, planets are Muslim. So do they have to say I'm Muslim? No. Allah's nature, kulli, takween, tadbir, all these creation of ex nihilo, ex materia, is all Allah's creation, and they're submitted towards Allah. You tell me who submitted? Your heart is pumping. Who is, the heart is submitted to Allah. Can you control your heart? No. So this utter mechanism of tadbir is praising hamd of Allah naturally. This is it. This is Islam. Ibrahim was a Muslim. He doesn't need to say, because it is not naturally proving it. I hope you understand. So what Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has to follow? Sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salam. What in Surah Al-An'am chapter 6 verse 161? قُلْ إِنَّنِي هَدَانِي رَبِّي إِلَى سِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ دِينًا قِيَامًا مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell to the people that I am following the millah, the sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salam too. I'm following his sunnah too. Why? Because he was not among the polytheists. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي, say my salat, my prayers, my rites and my sacrifices, all are for you, O Lord of the worlds. Chapter 6, verse 161. This is what Muhammad s.a.w. proclaiming. And you say he's not a prophet? Do you think that did bring any sensible person and tell him, the person who claims these kind of things, high morality, is he not a prophet? And you call him antichrist? Astaghfirullah. How dare you people? How unjust you people are. Jews are calling Jesus bastard, inverted commas, in Tel Aviv programs, in their dramas, in their melodrama, in their monologues, in their dialogues, in their movies, in their culture. They are portraying Jesus, abusing him, insulting him, insinuating him continuously, and then they make South Park cartoon, the South Park. And the cartoon, they are defaming your God, whatsoever you believe, this holy God, this Santa Claus, defame after defame, insinuation after insinuation, and you people are not shaking, not moving at all. We Muslims cannot tolerate, or could not tolerate, anything a blasphemy stuff against Muhammad the Arabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as well as all the prophets, including Jesus Christ. What you talking about? You want to tell us the teaching, the things of morality? You people are spineless, you, the Western culture. You people are senseless. You people are so tolerant that you don't even care what they are telling to your God, and you believe him is to be God. You are so insensitive now that, we are pity on you people. The guy is calling you that Jesus was a bastard, inverted commas, and we kill you. We are proud of it. The Jewish lad was telling on the live TV, we killed Jesus, and we are proud of it. And we Muslims said Jesus was not killed. He was respected messenger of God, and we believe him to be one of the righteous messengers of God. وَجِيهًا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَمِنَ الْمُقَرَّبِينَ وَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. He was chosen. He was Jesus Christ, the statue of Jesus Christ, that he has been blessed in this world and hereafter, and he will be near to the company of God. His Maryam chosen above the women of all nations, that the God Almighty has purified thee, mutaharaki, and purified thee and mutaharaki, and chosen above the women of all nations. This sublime nature of stature and praising is not to be found even in the Bible. And you people call us antichrist. Shame on your attitude. Call those people antichrist who abusing Jesus Christ, which is boiling our heart as well as yours. But you, unfortunately, those Jews have made you like rocks, and your heart is senseless. You people don't even know. You people are so much insensitive that anyone can abuse you, whatever they feel like you and do to you, and you are happy to take it. This is not something, this is a shame and disgrace on Western culture and civilization. Down to the mire, down to the gutter. Anyways, so this was lecture about Ibrahim al-Islam religion. Tell us, what was his religion? Don't talk extra with us. Religion name, you don't have it, Quran gave you, he was a Muslim. And automatically Allah says Muhammad has to follow Ibrahim, Millat Ibrahim, because he was not among the polytheists, idol worshiper and trinity worshiper. So this concept, Allah says, Jews and Christian, tell me, why are you disputing about Ibrahim when Torah and Injil, when gospel and law were not written? They were written after him. So when they were written after him, then the topic of discussion of Christianity being truth or Judaism is gone. Then what was he? He was a devoted Muslim. Moses never said when he was there on earth that my religion is Judaism. Never, find one statement. Jesus Christ never said that my religion is Christianity. This Christianity, Christian's word, Christianity is not even there in the Bible. In the Antioch, this book of Acts, the enemies of the Christ, they call him that these are Christians, meaning the follower of Christ, Messiah, not even God. Christ means Messiah, Messiah, we believe it. Isa ibn Maryam, Messiah, Messiah, and Quran says it. Similarly, if you see Moses, never said, the Jews never said for Moses and even the Bible that Moses, we are Judaism. This word is coming from the word Judea, people living in Judaism, meaning the concept of Judah in Judea. These all terminologies are concocted and coined. They are all prostituted. But the real word is Islam. You don't need to say it. You don't need to say it. Every person, I'm ending with this, Prophet ﷺ says, every child is born with the fitra of Islam. How? Because he has no label. Islam doesn't need a label. It's a fitra, natural mechanism of materialism, or you call it ruhani, spiritualism. He is totally depending of Allah on Allah. He's submitted, he already submitted. He's helpless little creature. He submitted himself already. He doesn't need to say it. But after that, once human beings grow up, they have their own sense and intellect. Then Allah puts them into the test of right and wrong. But they are Muslim. Prophet ﷺ says that whatever you are labeled is Jews, Christian, this all, these labels you acquired after your parents, from your parents, sorry, when you grow up. Otherwise, you are Muslim. If a child dies in early age, before the age of desperation, he's going to Jannah according to Islam. Not like Roman Catholics. Any person born in any house, any religion, if he dies before the age of discretion, before the age of self-actualization, Prophet ﷺ said he will go to Jannah. He's forgiven. Even if it's a Jewish person, Jewish lad. Once he started having sense and then he accepted the wrong ways with dalil and evidence and pro, all things are in front of his eyes, then Allah will punish him not being accepting the truth. This is all thing. That is why Jesus says, seek ye the truth, it shall set you free. وَآخِرُ الدَّعْوَانَ عَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ